Hello, marhaba, shlonkum ahwalkum. What's up everybody and welcome back with another video here with Rami the Iraqi. So today this video is part two of Iraqi expressions. I'm gonna go ahead and leave a link for you to watch part one in the description and also on the screen. So let's go ahead and dive into it. We have seven of them. The first one is shawarat beak. Shawarat beak. So you can't really translate that. But shawarat beak means like it's karma, right? So let's say you and your friend are out and you're both drinking something and then you drop your drink and then your friend start laughing at you. And then after 5-10 minutes, he drops his drink. So it's karma. So he will tell you shawarat biye, shawarat biye. So biye is me, like biye. Beak is you. Beach is you for a female. So shawarat biye, something like that. The next thing that we have, and you probably have heard it before, sheku maku. So sheku is like what's there, right? And maku is like nothing, you know what I mean? So it doesn't literally make sense, but if you want to translate sheku maku, it will be what's up, and it's used a lot. Sheku maku. So if you want to say what's up in the Iraqi dialect, it's sheku maku. And I think in other dialects, I don't think there's a slang to say what's up. But in the Iraqi dialect, we use sheku maku. The next thing that we have is verboni buri. So verboni is someone hit you, right? Dharab, the verb yadrob. So verboni is someone like is hitting you, it's hitting me. Verboni is conjugated for I. Verboni buri. Buri is a pipe, okay? Buri is a pipe. So it literally means someone hit you with a buri, okay? But if you want to translate it, it doesn't mean that someone is literally hitting you, okay? I mean, yes, someone could hit you with a buri and then they're going to say, rah adrobak buri. What it means is someone is ditching you, right? So let's say you both wanted to go out, okay? And you're meeting up with your friend and your friend didn't show up. So you would say, dharabni buri, dharabni buri. Or if it's a group of people, then dharboni buri, dharboni buri. Okay, so they didn't show up, they ditched you. And the next one is ahu. Ahu is also hard to translate, but I'll give you an example. Let's say someone is talking about the same topic every time. Okay, so one of your friends, every time you see them, they talk about the same topics every time. And then in your mind, you're like, ahu, yeah, he's still talking about the same topic every time. Or you could say to their face, ahu, dawakhitne. Dawakhitne is like, you're making me dizzy. All right, so like, stop talking, ahu. Or something bad happened, ahu. Something like that. So that's how you could use ahu. Then the next one is la'bo bine toba. So la'bo is conjugated for we. So they played la'bo bine with us. Toba means ball. Okay, toba means ball. So in the Iraqi dialect for ball we say toba. For the modern standard Arabic it's kura, kura. So لعبوا بينا طوبة. They played a ball with us, okay? It doesn't literally mean they played ball with you, but it means like someone is kind of like dragging you around. So let's say you just moved in this place and then the next month the landlord tells you, sorry, you gotta move out. And then you move out somewhere else. And then the landlord also tells you, sorry, you gotta move out. So you're literally being dragged everywhere. So these landlords, لعبوا بيك طوبة. So لعبوا بينا طوبة is they played or they dragged us around. So that's what it means in this context. All right, so we have two more and then we're good to go. Quick video for you guys today. So the next one is على راسي. So على is on, راسي is my head, راس. راس is head. على راسي means you're literally like, you're not literally putting someone on the head, but it's a way to saying, I got you, don't worry. I'm gonna put it on top priority on my list. So they use this a lot when you, let's say you go to a shop to buy something. Like, hey, can I get one falafel, one shawarma? على راسي, تدلل. تدلل means you got it also. Like, I'm gonna do it for you, don't worry. So على راسي can be used in this context. Anything that you wanna do something to someone, like if someone asks you to do something, you say على راسي, okay? Consider it done, I got you. Don't worry, on my head, on the top of my priority. So this is how, what على راسي kind of means. And the next and last one is يطير فياله. So يطير is a verb for flying, okay? Flying, like you're trying to fly something. فيل, فيل is elephant. فياله is the plural of elephant, elephants, okay? So يطير فياله is someone that is flying elephants or trying to fly elephants. You know how some people, they fly birds? I don't know, it could be a Middle Eastern thing, but it's kind of a hobby. You see in Iraq, a lot of people had birds and then they go and they fly them. They fly them, they fly around and then they do this with the white thing and then the birds come back to the cage and stuff. So, يطير فياله means he's flying elephants. So, it doesn't really make sense, right? But if you think about it, you can't fly elephants. Elephants are really, really, really heavy. So it's someone saying fake stuff, okay? So let's say someone says, today I jumped off of a building. So you would think in your mind tell him, كافي الطير فياله. كافي الطير فياله is stop flying elephants. Okay, like stop lying. Like you did not jump off of a building and you're talking to me right now and you're fine. So الطير فياله literally means like someone is exaggerating. And that's how you use it against them because they're kind of lying. So I hope you enjoyed today's short video. As usual, thank you for the support. And I have more exciting things coming for you in the next episodes. And I will see you next time.